There's a new study out that suggests the body's massive immune response to COVID-19 may cause the most severe symptoms in patients and not the virus itself. Here to answer your questions about that is Dr. Elise Worsell, an infectious disease specialist at Tufts Medical Center. Good to see you, doctor. Thanks for being with us.
Okay, off the top, doctor, you have treated some patients who have become very sick with COVID. So what do you think about this link between their illness and inflammation?
I think we knew about this since probably April or May of 2020, when we started treating people in the hospital with things that decreased your immune response. So medicines that were known to be used for rheumatological conditions and other conditions to reduce the immune response. So I think the novelty of this specific article after reviewing it is that they've isolated in a specific immune cell. But overall, we've known this for a long time, that it's not, the virus sets off a cascade of events, which is then the immune responses, unfortunately, sort of let go and free and causes problems.
Yep. All right, good to know that. So we know the risk of severe COVID symptoms is higher in people who are older or who have certain medical conditions like diabetes or obesity. So does this particular study offer any theories as to why that is?
I mean, I think as you get older, your systems that are in place for repairing, so something goes wrong and then there's a repairing system in the body, is not as brisk and cannot respond as quickly. And that's true in the setting of people with diabetes, and that's true for obesity, that overall the body does not recover as quickly because it just can't respond as quickly. So I think... Overall, we do think about age, diabetes, obesity as being kind of higher inflamed states
right.
than someone who is younger without these illnesses.
Are you less likely to develop inflammation from COVID if you've been vaccinated or already tested positive for the virus?
I don't think they've actually done the studies looking for the actual inflammatory markers, or at least I haven't read them. I would think absolutely. I would think absolutely that you are less likely to develop, if you're less likely to die from COVID, if you get the vaccine, then you're going to be less likely to show any signs of inflammation from COVID if you've gotten the vaccine. Right.
Can you make any connection between or any link between inflammation and long COVID, doctor?
I think the whole story on long COVID is really interesting. I think there's a lot of good research starting about it. We know that viruses, other viruses, set off inflammatory pathways that lead to symptoms like people are experiencing in long COVID. So viruses can trigger this. So I think it is interesting. I don't really think most of us think that someone with the feelings of long COVID still has the virus replicating in them, but rather it has set off an unfortunate cascade of events, which makes the person feel continuously ill.
Dr. Worsell, thanks for your time. Great to see you.
Thank you, doctor. Thanks. Stay well.